Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 116 of A.S.A., my Q&A series where I answer your questions. I got six beautiful questions today, but before I get into those, I would like to say that if you have any questions for the next episode of A.S.A., you can leave them in the comments of this video, and I will answer them in episode 117. And while you're down there, if you would be oh so kind and generous to leave a like, I would greatly appreciate it. And I don't like to ask people to subscribe. I've always thought it was just kind of like cheesy and whatever. So I'm like, if you guys are watching my content, would you consider doing so? I don't know. I'm not going to like bug or push, but if you're willing to subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. Now let's get into the question, starting with Mayo Husko. A.S.A., why did you reboot A.S.A. after you said you were going to stop at episode 100 and then a potato? Thank you for the potato. Simple answer.
I lied.
Okay, though I technically didn't really lie, I just honestly changed my mind, you know? Like, we're all human, right? We change our minds. Sometimes you think you have a great idea and then it's like, never mind. I was initially going to end it because I was just honestly kind of getting tired of it, even though I only do it every other Wednesday. I thought, I don't really want to do this anymore. But then shortly after, I kind of just changed my mind and was like, no, I want to keep doing A.S.A. It's very fun because I do genuinely enjoy making A.S.A. episodes. I genuinely enjoy getting comments or questions and then answering them. And I'm actually glad that I didn't end A.S.A. because A.S.A. has been doing better than ever, and it's still a ton of fun to make. Hooray! Next question is from Brick Collection. A.S.A., favorite Star Wars Legends character? And then a couple potatoes. Thank you for the potatoes. To be completely honest with you, I'm not much of a Star Wars Legends fan. I don't really know anything about Star Wars Legends, but I've always had like, kind of like an attachment, if you will, to Darth Revan. I've always thought he's just a cool looking character. I know literally nothing about him. The overall design of him is just so very cool. I just absolutely love Darth Revan, mostly for the design and the name. I mean, Revan, that's a cool name. Right? I don't really know anything about Star Wars Legends or the character, but I do like Darth Revan. Next question is from B. Brick Able. A.S.A., hyped for May the 4th? I absolutely am hyped for May the 4th. My wallet is not, but I definitely am. There's going to be a lot of fantastic and just amazing LEGO Star Wars sets coming out. I'm really excited for that buildable Droidica. It looks really cool. And then there's going to be the pod racing diorama, which it's just okay to me. I'm not a huge fan of the dioramas, but I definitely will still be picking it up. And then, of course, there's a Sith Infiltrator, which I'm really excited for that, because as of right now, I don't own any Sith Infiltrators other than the Microfighter, and that doesn't count. Poor Squidward. Another thing I'm super duper ultra mega excited about is the TIE Interceptor UCS set. Like, I love TIE Interceptors, and so UCS TIE Interceptor, yes please.
Hello, what about me?
No, you're not in this episode.
And then the best part about getting them all for May the 4th is then there'll be some promos. I believe there's going to be like a keychain, a poly bag, and then a droid carrier set, which is going to be like the exclusive set for this year for May the 4th. Personally, I don't think that's the greatest idea for a set, but it does fit the 25 year anniversary of The Phantom Menace. So I'm like, that's pretty cool. And the last three questions are from EK Starlord. A.S.A., what is your thoughts on the Star Wars Acolyte trailer? And then a bunch of potatoes. Thank you for the potatoes. To be completely honest with you, I don't hate the Acolyte trailer. I don't hate the Acolytes. I don't think like, oh, it's going to be a terrible, awful, terrible, just horrible, disgusting, bad show. I don't really think it's going to be amazing either. I'm still going to watch it. Even if I don't end up liking the first few episodes, once I start watching it, I'll finish the show. I'm not really hyped for it, and the trailer didn't hype me up anymore. One thing that I am a little worried about, but I don't really think it's going to be an issue, is continuity errors. Like, are they going to be like, oh, look, the Jedi discovered the Sith, because I believe the show takes place 100 years before episode 1. As we know, in episode 1, they discovered, oh, the Sith are back. I thought we killed them all, but apparently we didn't. And so I'm like, if the Acolyte is like, oh no, the Sith were alive in this time, then that's gonna be kind of weird. But I don't think they're gonna do that. It'll probably just be like either a dark Jedi or all the main characters are gonna die. So really, all I should have said is, I'm not hyped for the show, but I'm gonna watch it. But I also don't think it's horrible, and I don't know why it's getting so much hate. Next question, A.S.A., do you think Grogu should be a Jedi or a Mandalorian? And then a bunch of potatoes. Thank you for the potatoes. Technically, he's gonna be both, right? Because at the end of season 3, he was officially adopted as Din Djarin's basically kid because he's sworn into their religion or creed or whatever it's called. He's considered a Mandalorian. So if he becomes a Jedi, then he will be a Jedi Mandalorian. And the last question, A.S.A., have you ever seen the TV show called The Orville, and then a bunch of potatoes. I don't know if I said that right. No, I have not. I'm pretty sure it's Star Trek, or it looks like Star Trek, and I don't do Star Trek. I'm too cool for that. So, no, I have not watched it, and I'm not going to. But that's going to do it for today's episode of ASA. Thank you all very much for your questions. I appreciate each and every one of you. Like I said in the beginning of this episode, if you have a question for the next episode, leave it down below so I can answer in the next episode. Leave a like while you're down there. I greatly appreciate it. And last thing I want to say is if you want to check out some of my LEGO Star Wars shorts that I recently did, I now have all three of the Starship Collection, or mini scale as I like to call them, up on YouTube. They're just quick little short reviews, so if you want to check them out, they're available in the cards. But yeah, so that's it for today. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye!